All right.
So,
There's no one watching yet. There's no point. Like,
well,
I haven't even put a message in. Well, we've gone live, so our subscribers will hear that Ludicast is now live casting a pub game
yeah.
for five. Oh, there's actually four viewers. Fuck, is this just us?
I'm not there yet.
Maybe
I'm
then.
not watching.
Okay, I'm watching. Hey guys,
Microphone muted. Microphone
is there a
activated.
delay on this?
No.
Isn't there?
Well, like 10 seconds maybe because it
Oh,
has to upload.
okay. Hi guys, welcome to Ludicast casts a pub game. We were going to be casting Boats Don't Leave Footprints versus Drinkdotka Win Vodka in their tiebreaker for the second position in their group. However, Drinkdotka Win Vodka fucking bailed, despite me running like 2 miles in under 20 minutes to get here and cast a game with a fucking bass guitar on my back. This is just dedication to casting. It's pretty much all it is, and what can I say? I am the most dedicated, apart from Sapped, but none of us can reach those levels. So
Excuse
this
me?
is. Yeah, fuck you, you suck. Anyway, this is going to be a very informal cast of a pub game. We're basically just going to be taking the piss out of everyone because we all get set up to cast and are very disappointed in there not being a game. So stay tuned for what is going to be absolute mayhem. These guys are upper division, I think.
Well,
Though
I'm
it's
just
going to be
gonna be
like.
completely serious as always.
Are you actually?
Yeah.
You need to do a funny voice, though.
Do I?
You need to do
Wait,
like a
wait, wait,
French
wait.
accent.
I can do that.
You need to.
I have a tool for that. One second.
You what? You have a tool for a funny accent?
Not for a funny
It's
accent.
called your vocal cords. You use them
Yeah.
like this, mate. I'm from Australia. That's pretty good, though. I spent a year in Australia. I should know what they sound like. Can't this, can't that. Fuck you, dingo. All that nonsense. Oh,
So,
drover!
does it work?
I never. No. They
No?
sound normal. No.
Oh, damn it.
They sound
Okay.
absolutely normal. I'm typing a message in Discord. Someone fill the blank space. The white noise. Zapped.
They're
Go
actually
on.
playing Captain's Mod. Oh.
Yeah, it's the point. It's like it's gonna be an actual thing.
Oh.
But just,
All
you
right.
know, it's a pub. And they're versing some
Wait.
Ruskies.
My
What?
draft screen isn't really working. It's like just black. Sorry,
I
guys.
still see the Requiem Autumn screen.
Yeah.
Just get rid of all the overlay. This is not inform this is
I know.
informal.
I'm trying, but it's not working. Like the in-game thing is
Informal
just
cast.
black.
I see it. It is black. They've banned
Yes.
Draw, Void, Silencer, and Axe so far. Why is it not working?
I
Did you
don't
just get
know.
rid of the overlay? Hold on, the overlay's
Yes.
gone.
Yes,
Now
I
it's
know
just
it's gone.
black.
Yes. I'm trying.
Except for our social media handlers, where you can follow us at youtube.com/tonguelayer and Twitter at Ludicast underscore. Fact. Tonguelayer, honestly, this is like.
Wow.
We've dropped two viewers now. I'll be
Okay.
happy.
Yeah, that's all my fault.
This is pretty much just me and Zap that are watching now.
Why is that not working?
Yourself
It has to be a new Dota update which killed it.
Ooh, a dazzle pick.
Ooh, a dazzle. Dazzle disruptor pick. Dazzle disruptor. D's. Do you reckon you can get a draft? No, you can't get a draft with just D's. There's not that many heroes to begin with D.
Okay, I'm just gonna restart the stream. Be right back.
BRB, guys. Oh my god, it's still D though! Dazzle disruptor Darkseer. Who else begins with D?
A
Dumb.
draw?
Dim.
Dire team ban.
I can't do all the talking. You realize that?
I
You're gonna
just had to
practice.
load back in. So, okay, let's
Are
analyze
we live?
that.
Are we
Yes,
actually live?
boats don't leave footprints. Desert Omni Knight. The
Yeah, but
thinking
see, like,
behind that
they
is,
had Dazzle, they had
yes.
Disruptor, they had Darkseer, and they could have had Death Prophet, Dragon Knight, and Doom,
Well, we
but they didn't.
okay.
They went for Omni Knight.
Why?
So unless I'm
You
gonna
can't just do
spell.
that.
Oh, is there another hero that begins with O?
Oracle.
Ogre?
They need to go Oracle or Ogre, and then Medusa, and then pick Doom.
Yeah, I think Oracle would fit Doom, in really good.
It spells Doom.
OD?
OD, OD works, yeah. So it spells Doom, and then they pick Doom at the end.
Yeah, that's yeah, they have to do that, that's true. I'd be really disappointed if they don't.
You need to take off the delay, Tangly, so they can...
There is no delay.
Oh, there is no delay, alright.
I think... So, what I wanted to say about Omni, and the other thing, Dazzle, that's what you have to do right now in the meta, that's what pros are doing, or at least EG is, picking two very defensive supports, like Dazzle Omni Knight, Oracle Omni Knight, Shadow Demon Omni Knight, it's just super strong right now. The, thing is, if no one dies on your team, you pretty much win every fight, so... It does work really well.
I'm not listening. Sorry. What?
Never mind.
Do you know that's actually what happens when we draft, except I just try and make something up that I think you've been talking about?
I know. Of course.
So that it ties together?
Yes.
You're just like white noise. You're like,
I know, yeah.
And I'm on Discord.
Like, even if we're playing a league game, I'm just white noise.
Feet? Did you say feet? I can feet. Okay. They've not banned any heroes that begin with O. No! Oh, wait, I suppose they can still spell Doom. In fact, they can spell Doom. D-d-doom. Or they can. They just need to pick... Who did you say? Oracle and... Ogre.
Yeah.
Ogre, yeah.
What?
No!
Is there a hero that begins... No, there's not even a hero that begins with Y or K.
Oh, Radiant only has picked Intelligence Hero. Oh.
Oh.
Might be a pattern.
Oh. Oh.
And if boats don't leave footprints, pick like a Strength now and then an Intelligence, we got like... Synergy.
This is why we don't let you talk.
Yeah.
You realize that, right?
That's a synergy there.
This is why you're stats, man.
Yeah.
Lost my teaspoon. This is actually a disaster. Nyx Assassin.
Yeah, no, I guess.
He can't really burst anyone down. I mean, I suppose.
Wow.
Darkseer's not inherently tanky until they
Disruptor?
Get like, mech and Greaves.
Hey, there's Oracle.
Dude, we've got Ooh. Do. We've got Do.
Is there a hero... Well, Magnus? What else? With M? Is it only Magnus?
Mirana,
oh, right.
There's others. 5 seconds remaining. Mirana, Magnus, and more, here, on Lucha
Morphling,
Cast.
Meepo.
Morphling, Meepo. You're looking it up, you little tit, don't cheat. And like, you know all these heroes.
So... They got 4 int heroes now against Nyx.
No help to look up.
That's some mana burn. That's some mana burn issues right there. Mm-hmm. Right, hold on. I literally need to go and get a teaspoon, because without that I can't drink tea. Zap, you're in charge, not Tungler.
Have it.
So?
So, yes, on the Radiant, we also have like this color pattern. It's like blue, purplish.
How's OD blue?
OD is blue.
He's not blue, he's green.
I'm turquoise.
No.
It's blue.
That's
now.
Green.
No.
Yes.
Like the background is blue.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm looking at OD right now. Alright, maybe a little bit. 10 seconds remaining.
Anti-mage. Well, I just wanted to say it, Anti-Mage against 4 Intelligence Heroes, obviously really strong, with Nyx mana burn. They don't really have anything to kill him, at all. Like, they got Disruptor with Disruptor Ultimate Glimpse, but then there's a Dazzle under Omni Knight, so if they're close, he's just not gonna die. They do need a solution to him right now.
I've got some good news.
Yes?
What?
When I went into the kitchen to find a teaspoon, I also found a chocolate eclair. So there's
not that good news. Now I want one too.
Well, I didn't say it was good news for you. That it was good news for me. What are boats don't leave footprints trying to spell? Dona. Donab. Donor. That's with an... Donor kebab. That's with an A, right? Or is it an E?
Ooh, what?
The kebab. Like the donor meat. Is that with an A or an E?
Where?
Like, how do you spell the word?
D-O-N-E-R.
There's no letter that, called U.
Yes, there is. In German, there actually is.
There's no letter called U.
Yes. It's an O with two dots above it. That's an U.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. Alright. Like, I'm sure you know better.
I have a degree in German.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, ich bin ein Schnitzel.
Alright.
Look.
You can't say it's wrong.
What?
You can't say it's wrong.
Yes, I can.
No, it's not wrong.
How's it not wrong?
Because you don't know.
Huh?
Right? You don't know if I'm a schnitzel or not.
Well, you're talking, so it can't be schnitzel.
That's just fucking... That's not on. That's so...
Racist.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Schnitzelist, I'll call it. Okay. Magnus, Mirana, Medusa,
so,
Meepo...
I'm pretty sure they only picked Shadow Fiend because I already won with an Anti-Mage pick. So it doesn't really matter if you have a shitty mid hero.
He's not that shitty. If you leave him out of 10, then he's not that shitty. Anyway, Russian stack, or whatever you are, with the guy who's got... I think that's Korean letters as well. I don't even know. I don't want to sound biased or bigoted on the internet.
Someone needs to tell them we're casting their game.
I don't think they care. How can we can't even message them.
We can message Boats Don't Leave Footprints and tell them they should. Tell them.
But then they'll watch the cast.
So what? Gonna delay?
Only 3 minutes, though.
That's fine. Spectre, yeah. That doesn't help.
Deduce. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and say... I like Hove. I think Hove played really well in the last game that we cast him in. And I think in a Nyx with this setup of heroes, he's going to have a field day with mana burn.
I mean, he can't do anything wrong, right? No matter who he clicks, it's always going to be great. So,
yeah.
But how is Spectre? Oh no, Spectre's on their team. Who's our carry? Anti-Mage. See, they have a Darkseer. That's pretty good, right? Against Anti-Mage?
No.
Yeah, Anti-Mage gonna have a hard lane.
Well, in the lane, yeah.
Darkseer.
Yeah.
But
also Darkseer Illusions, they burn mana from wall, right?
Then there's Omni-Knight though with Repel.
So Repel that's... Two Repels is his entire mana pool, and it's on like a really long...
Not really, Repel's 50 mana.
Is it?
He has 278 mana. They can use it like
so
five
times,
and has a Clarity.
Six Repels with like...
And a Thor Ring Recipe. So I don't think he's ever going to run out of mana by spamming Repel.
What's the
right
cooldown
now?
Of Repel?
14 seconds.
Cooldown on Isle Shell is like 8.
Well, you can just look it up, right? By clicking at them.
I can,
it's 9.
I can do it now, it's not an official cast.
Microphone muted. Microphone activated.
Well, it is an official cast. It's a pub game. Secured top rune. I'm on free camera, so it's just showing me the top rune. The Mad Monocle. He was good last time as well, wasn't he? Mad Monocle.
Yeah. Did he play at Mirana?
You know, did he not play the Invoker in the second game?
Yeah, right. Yeah, that was Invoker.
Okay, so how does Shadow Fiend do against OD?
Terrible. Like against every other hero.
If he gets levels in Arcane Orbs, he's going to start melting. He's only got like 1 mana, 2 under the tower, but... I mean, there's not much OD can do to deny him farm if he gets raises, but yeah,
oh, what?
OD's smart.
There's a lot OD can do to deny him farm. Just imprison him all the time. And he's
13 mana body.
Can't do anything. Yeah.
Okay, so this is like... Of all the heroes that Darkseer wants to play up against, there's a few that are terrible. Oracle, Omni-Knight, Doom's pretty good because you can devour the creep. So it's not the greatest lane for Darkseer to be in. But is he going to die against a Dazzle and Omni-Knight? I don't think so.
No. That not, but... Then again, they have no answer whatsoever to Intermage. So I don't see them losing the game, honestly, if they don't fuck up.
Doubt, how does Antimage do against Spectre?
Pretty good.
Antimage has the edge, yeah. you'd think.
I haven't played that lineup, but I think Antimage has like more of a fighting and split pushing advantage.
I think even it's a timing
with,
thing. Like between 30 and 45 minutes, Antimage is probably better. But later on, when Spectre catches up in farm, because Antimage is gonna farm faster, she's probably gonna win. Like in the ultra late game, she's better at least one on one, I think.
Oh, my Monaco's having a pretty hard time in mid. It's got no mana. I didn't see how many lasses. It doesn't look like that many though.
Yeah, that's just.
I looked it up, and Antimage versus Spectre. Antimage have like 4.5% advantage.
Really?
That's huge.
That's more than the Medusa, so it's pretty good.
Interesting. We'll just have to see how it plays out.
Yeah.
In the end, doesn't really matter.
Who is playing the Antimage? Simply Jack.
The thing with Shadow Fiend is there's absolutely no reason right now to pick him, because everything he does, someone else can do better. It's just a really shitty hero right now.
Why do you hate Shadow Fiend so much?
I don't hate it. I think the hero is really cool, but it's just super bad. Like, why would you pick Shadow Fiend over Invoker, for example? Like, there's no reason. Invoker just does everything Shadow Fiend does, just better.
Dank Shadowblade into Aghanim Scepter ult.
Well, first of all,
that's
terrible, going X. but then, like, Invoker just throws EMP Tornado, that does the same thing, or his Deafening Blast Meteor combo on top. Like, yeah, that's even a little bit more reliable.
Watching very safe game so far. How's the Nyx doing?
He's alright.
He's alright. Well, levels. 3-3. Eh, it's fine. It's fine. I mean, who has?
Looking at the last hit though, Antimage with 23 last hit at 4 minutes. It's pretty good.
Better than the Spectre, 11
yeah.
Meter, 10 to 10, and that's a bit surprising seeing the Spectre doesn't really have much to contend with. Her support should be helping. Actually, Nyx is just going to right click her, and with the the Impale is off the mark. That's most unfortunate. Hella unfortunate. Oh, they find the Disruptor in the mid lane. Omni Knight and Dazzle are going to start chasing him down and whacking on him, but he's going to go throughout the kinetic field and halt in your steps. Give me a rotation, chucking out a Thunderstorm, but he's just going to purify. Propel himself.
Oh, Spectre in danger though.
Oh, Spectre in danger though. Shows out the dagger. Nyx has no mana and he's tanking some of the tower hits with Oracle's cooldown on 1 second for his Fate's Edict, whatever it is. Fortune's End. So gonna get the Fortune's End onto him and he's stuck in the trees. He is actually held in place for a little bit. Ping, 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 ping. It says Spectral Dagger on cooldown in 1 second, but no mana to use it. So Nyx is actually just gonna scuttle out of danger. A little bit of danger there, but nothing he can't handle. What happened to your voice modifier, Tungler?
It doesn't work, apparently.
Same. So Dazzle and Omni Knight are in this bottom lane now. They probably shouldn't leave Antimage alone, because if he is alone, he can get fucked by Ion Shells, but they seem confident in just leaving him there. First blood! Shadow Fiend diving in between the two towers.
He actually tapped question mark before he killed him. That's next level.
I didn't see it. I'm not on game chat. Oh. Question mark. That's disqualified from Requiem Autumn Blitz 2 League right there. Inspector just kills Omni Knight. All a go, and actually, Dazzle might be in a bit of danger. No, he's fine.
Omni Knight is level 2. How'd you do that?
Batanius, get your fucking game on, bruv. Not even level 3 yet. He's got his Soul Ring, though. Come on, dude. Head in the game.
I mean, I guess that's the problem with Omni Knight, right? He's just. absolutely useless on the landing stage. Like, it's like he's not there, pretty much.
Are you joking?
No. Actually not.
I won, me and Corpy, I won 1v1 mid. Well, I was up against a Triumph Protector, because it was funny as fuck. But I won mid Omni Knight. Didn't die once the whole game, had Skadi, Sanjin Yasha.
Wait a second. There's a small difference between mid Omni Knight and support Omni Knight in what you do in your lane. Just
like,
slightly.
It's more of the same thing, except
no.
you've got
no.
someone else to help you kill them.
No, that's why you're terrible at supporting. It actually isn't.
You bash them with your big hammer.
No, you don't.
You smack them, keep
no.
smacking them. Then
oh
when
god.
You come back in for a smack, you heal yourself, heal bomb.
Why do I have to cast with two core players?
And then you keep
players?
Smacking them.
Oh.
Funny, because I'm not even a core. My GPM is so bad, I may as well be a support half the time.
Yeah, that's true. So.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm
so
core for both of us.
Why you don't do that, Dunk, as a support, is you don't want to leech experience from your carry.
You're not
at all.
Leeching experience if you're
what?
Like, if you're forcing them back because you're bashing them with the hammer, you're not leeching XP because you're outside the range of the creeps.
Well, good luck forcing the usual offlaner back with an Omni Knight.
If you're fucking farming here, and you just run the other.
I don't know where he is.
Oh, you can't see my pings.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Here, right here, and then you just get them here, and then force them back to here.
Yeah, right.
And you win.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Easy peasy. I'm always right. When am I ever wrong?
So, my point is, Omni Knight is absolutely useless in lane. The only thing he can do is stack and pull. So he does need another zoning support in his lane. He doesn't work in a dual lane,
are
unless
you saying
it's
this
aggro
because,
off lane.
Are you saying this because you were a support Omni Knight once and you couldn't make it work?
No. I'm saying that because that's how it is. And you see it here. Like, Omni Knight level 2 at 5 minutes, level 3 at 8 minutes. There's just nothing he can do right now to. That is
Where
not
is
I stay in lane and lead experience and do nothing.
Oh, he's going for the last hit on the catapult. Is he going to get it?
No.
Oh, anti-mage. I'd have used my heal there. I'd have used heal to secure that last hit.
I know. Dire's bottom tower is
under attack. Anyway.
That would just be jungle farming right now for his radiance.
Oh, they're gonna rotate behind on the darks here. He's got level 2 surge, but the slow is gonna do hee haw.
You should have repaired him there to purge surge. That probably works, right?
Oh, no. I don't think so.
Why not?
I don't think
if you
so.
Can purge iron shell, why not surge?
I'm looking it up.
He's looking it up. There we go. That's man Zap doing his job. What a player. What a guy. Oh my god, look at Shadow Fiend. Oh my god, he's double stacking the camps with these illusions.
That's so pro.
Mad Monocle literally on another level. I can't like even begin to fathom.
It's actually fairly easy
how
to
you,
do.
How you would do that. Like, no, it's impossible.
Yeah, yeah.
It's nearly
for
impossible.
You.
No, like in general. I don't even think like Poppy could do that.
Yeah,
he's pretty
yeah,
good.
You're probably right.
Nom nom. As he eats a ward in the bottom lane. British just showing off because he knows that there's casters. We're watching you, don't worry. We're taking critique. There you go. This is what you do on Omni Knight, right? Bash, bash,
mm-hmm.
bash. And then you take damage, and then you just heal yourself back up.
And then you run away because you can't fight him. And you didn't achieve anything.
Here he goes again. Here he goes
yeah, okay.
again on his own. Look, bash.
So what?
Go again, bash him.
What's he achieving here? Nothing.
He's got Vanguard now. Yeah, he's got Vanguard, so he's using nothing now. But he could have just kept bashing him.
But, yeah, but that bashing doesn't do anything because he leads to his experience
look,
from Nyx, who's nearly level 6.
Bash!
Yeah, and now he's gonna die. Spectre knows what he's doing.
Wanna see who's right? I'm right. Thanks, Spectre.
Okay.
Wanna see who's right? There we go. Mana burn. That's happening.
Alright, you can dispel the search, yeah.
Well, who's right now?
With any dispel.
What's he doing? Okay.
Rip Shadowfiend.
I missed that, what happened?
He ran into multiple people and died. I'm not sure what he wanted to do, but...
Kill! Mad Monocle. Proving that pros don't necessarily have to play like a pro. Oh, kill the courier with the illusion! Nah, not on point. Not even on point. Okay, so now Brutus is in the mid lane. This is a good lane for him, right? He just takes last hits and a lot of farm, and essentially he can have Skadi by 20 minutes. Yeah. If he's farming well.
It's also a really, really good matchup against OD. What can he really do?
Nothing. Yeah. He can do nothing against Omni Knight. Because let's face it, Omni Knight doesn't need mana. Why would you need mana on Omni Knight? You just, you
I don't
have
know.
A hammer.
I just get stats anyway.
Well, that's a bit silly. Like, there's pro plays and then there's just sheer silliness. And I think that categorizes under there. Oh, it's Disco Spider! I forgot he was on this team. MVP player name. There's no one else on the other team. I kind of like. I kind of like want to see who is right, because he's just this. Like that name suggests that he knows he's right, no matter what is going on. He's just right. But at the same time,
yeah,
he's not an electronically music motivated arachnid.
Also, he's level 4 at minute 12.
Spectre.
Spectre? What?
Oh, I thought you meant Spectre.
No, Disco Spider.
That's fine. Dazzle doesn't have a hammer, so it's a little bit harder for him to like make his presence known in the early game. He's got to get a basher before he can do that.
Yeah. That's my go-to item build too.
Why wouldn't you get a basher?
You got to double damage now on Omni.
Good. Oh, this is a kill. This is
easy
a kill.
Kill on Oracle.
Just gotta smack him. Like, it's just so easy. Here he comes. Wanna see who is right? 71 plus 71, 142 Dama. Smack. Heal! No, that was a bit early. That was a bit early, Brutus. You gotta get more smacks in before then. But
and there goes the double
purge.
Damage.
So they're gonna purge the repel. And with the callback from dash 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 M5, Tanius, smack with your hammer. He uses the grave on the. Oh, it wasn't the Omni Knight. They're gonna turn this. MSS is gonna die to Dazzle, the right click of Disco Spider, just far too hardcore. And Anna Gray, or Sasha Gray, I probably presume to be. Is going to join the fight here. He's going to put an Iron Shell on himself and chase after Brutus, who's healed himself. But he's not bashing. And I fear this is the end. And it is OT. Oh my god, he turns up and he's doing so much damage.
It actually says Jin, not Anna.
It says what?
Jin.
Jim.
I think.
Jim. Like, short for James. Jim.
No. Jin. Like.
Jin. That's like a the alcoholic D. beverage.
And forget it. Yeah, something in that direction.
You mean like D-G-I-N, the Arabic genie? Or the Arabic...
What? Yeah, genie. Exactly. I'm not sure about the second letter, but I think so, yeah.
Okay. Anyone want to let us know what's going on there? Let us know. Jin. I like Jin. Pretty good.
Tangler?
Mm-hmm.
I think you want to change the stream name.
Do I? Is it not Team vs Mango Gaming?
Team vs Mango Gaming, yeah. This is literally what's going on just now.
Yeah.
Mango Gaming are on the Radiant and Team are on Footprint. Look how many last hits the Shadow Fiend has. That's because he's stacking those camps like a madman. Like a mad monocle. Heck. But all of Russian Stack are in the top lane. I don't want to call them Russian Stack. What should we call the Radiant? We get to come up with a name for them. Anyone?
Footprints.
Oh, never mind. There's action here. They're going to get all that shit onto Disco Spider, but he's going to make sure he's going to survive. Here comes Ultimate from Mad Monocle. No, he cancels it because he's on top of no one. And he actually might have to use it because they can see him. There's a sentry ward. I don't think Mad Monocle realizes because he's just standing there doing shit. With the Iron Charge and the last hit from Disruptor, he's going to make sure he falls. And with Mr. Letters killing the Omni Knight, he wasn't hitting them hard enough. They're going to get the... onto Simple Jack. He's going to get back into Storm, which seemed like a bit of overkill, but with the shock and the urn,
he's
that's
probably
dead.
Dead. Yeah.
No. 32 HP on. What a snipe from what I see. He was right. Oh no, it wasn't even a snipe.
No,
oh,
it
no,
follows
okay.
You.
Oh, I thought he sniped him there through the neutral cramp. Less impressive. I am unimpressed now. That was just Bogsander plays. But three falling.
It's just Shadow Fiend in a nutshell. You run in, think you're doing a lot of stuff, but then you realize you're a terrible hero and you die.
No, he was fine because he had an invis rune, but I'm not sure if his team didn't relay the fact that they were dewarding there, so obviously he had an obs, but they're just going to eclipse him right back to base.
Also, you went for Blink and Dagger first.
There's the purge that's going to fly all the way. Oh, they've got a Rod of Atos already on the Outworld Devourer, and he's going to just start hitting Water Disco Spider. Repel him! All you want, he's still going to die. Brutus, you're running into a whole heap of trouble here. Anti-Mage with the Impale coming out for the next assassin. Unfortunately, the heal wasn't actually going to connect, and with the Mana Void, it wasn't enough. He's going to put himself in a prism. And with the wall here, there's lots of their own heroes helping. The Oracle's going to use Fortune S to kill him, and another perfect ult from the OG. Triple kill from Tetris. And they're going to kill the Shadow Fiend as well. Double kill for Kupabik. Kupabik. I'm not sure how you actually pronounce that.
So, usually you don't want to fight into an OD.
It was a fucking disaster.
Yeah, who got 28 int at 60 minutes.
Pretty good.
It's just nothing you want to do, really. Especially not go back in on Shadow Fiend, who just died and has no swords. Also, they need anti-mage to farm. Like, his battle fury timing isn't terrible. It's actually pretty decent, but he needs to keep the farm up. Like, he can't fight them right now. He needs his Manta and maybe like an Abyssal Blade for and a BKB before he can fight OD. So he needs a few minutes more.
Sorry. That's all I heard. Wasn't listening again. As in Discord, we've got a request. We need to find a good team fight and a bad team fight. Someone wants them for a personal project. Do you get any examples from this game? Pretty bad team fight for Postal Leaf Footprints there.
User was kicked out of your channel. User joined your channel.
Fuck you! Fuck you, kick me. Kick me from TeamSpeak. This is what actually happens. I wasn't casting, I missed it. They killed the Oracle. Oh my god, Spectre, she's gonna ultimate behind the tower. Oh no, where is she? I don't even know. With the drawback and the hits, they are gonna have the next Dazzle, and he's really low, but he's got Shallow Grave on, but he also has Urn, which is gonna last longer. With the Weave out from the Dazzle, not the Weave, the Shallow Grave. Spectral Dagger! Boosh! From downtown. Want to see who is right on a killing spree. And with Shadow Fiend, unfortunately, stuck inside the static field. Ah, oh, heal! Heal and repel. OD put himself in the prism? Oh, he's pretty low. Oh, one raise, he's so close. Get him, get him. Is he gonna die? He is gonna die with a Thunderstrike. And then they can heal the Disruptor. Bash from Dazzle. Blah, 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 blah. But on the other side, oh my god, he's got no health, but he's wicked sick. He deals 186 damage at this point. 56 intelligence attacks, but here. Oh, he's anti-mage. This is easy. He's just gonna wait. He's just gonna wait this out. There's no escape for the OD. Oh, wait, he nearly fucking kills him though. Holy shit, that was some hard right click. He's not gonna die from Urn. Nah. That was close though. But if you want anyone to get a wicked kill streak, 880 gold.
Pissing right up in the network.
Sorry, I wasn't watching. What happened?
Basically, there was a cool team fight and Anti-Mage nearly died.
Okay, I hope I got that on camera.
Where were you? You're watching the secret shop again?
Yeah.
You do like that secret shop?
Uh-huh.
Hard to blame you with the cool little icon now. Little wigwam. Although, I've noticed, it lights up when someone's in the vicinity. Surely it doesn't do that for the enemy team.
It does.
What?
No way.
And it's a vision that lights it up. Like, the map gets brighter when you have vision there, so the icon on the map gets brighter too. But obviously not if you don't have vision.
Ah, that's clever. I thought it lit up. Like,
that'd
advertising
dumb.
That someone was in. That would be pretty dumb. We've already got scan. Can I scan? No, it's recharging. Okay, never mind. Where's Botanius? What's he up to? He got his scatty yet.
So, Zep, why would you ever go Vlad's on anti-mage?
Oh, no! Guys, I think Brutus is dead.
You wouldn't?
Okay.
Brutus
yeah.
is dead,
well,
guys.
They got a Shadow Fiend, so they got, like, a kind of a synergy. But still. So
yeah,
lands
no, they're not.
It's a waste of spot when you got like a Abyssal Blade.
Yes.
Which
okay, I agree.
Heals anti-mage enough.
I thought you went Vlad's if you were farming longer.
No, you just get Vanguard.
No, just get Vanguard.
There's really no reason to get Vlad's over Vanguard. Like, there's no benefit at all. Unless
you
want
to. You used to not get Vlad's though.
Yes, because you didn't want to get a Vanguard because it was bad. But now
I
that Vanguard builds into Abyssal Blade, it makes sense
yeah,
to
yeah.
get it.
Makes sense.
Well, you get some mana agent though. Like, that's the only thing I can see.
Yeah. I guess.
It's not exactly great for his team either, is it?
Well, it's kind of it's
good
better for your team to have the Vlad's and a Vanguard. But if he's farming anyway.
Spectre ult in the top lane. She's going to find Mad Monocle
oh,
and Disco
lane,
Spider. No, bot lane, top lane. It's a Shallow Grave. Mad Monocle's going to try and get the ultimate off with Disco Spider TPing out, but he's going to get put
oh,
inside the Astral
Prism. Oh, Darkseer in trouble.
Darkseer's dead. Darkseer. Oh, poor Darkseer. How did that happen?
Oh, this Raptor can glimpse.
No, he can't. He's repelled. He has glimpsed.
No, he's not.
No. Oh, he's all the way back.
That's a repel off in action.
Oh, no. This is so bad. They're topping the last hit charts as well. Like, Shadow Fiend and Anti-Mage have way more last hits than Spectre. Oh, no. M forward slash forward slash forward slash M5. You die to Simple Jack. Are they gonna run into? Oh, they find him. Oh, they're gonna get the thingy on. He's just hitting him. He's purged. He's hit. He's regenerating though.
Thanks for the heal, Oracle.
Thanks for the heal, Oracle. But he's gonna all himself about the fact that OT's already got a fucking staff of wizardry and a dragon lance, and he's building a four staff. I believe he. Oh, wait, what? Does he already have his Hurricane Pike? He's got the components.
Yes,
the
he does.
He
actually does.
He doesn't have four staff, does he?
Yes, he does.
Right, yeah.
I was kind of hoping that's it was madness. A Dagon for a second, but well.
Well, gives you in. Spectre has a Radiance and Vanguard at 22 minutes.
That's pretty good.
She's pretty much free to farm wherever she wants. And the beauty of Spectre, obviously, is that she can join team fights no matter where they are.
So, what's your thought about Shadow Fiend blink first, Zept, and into BKB?
It's horrible.
Yes, okay. Thanks for agreeing.
Like, what do you want to achieve with a blink against a Spectre with Radiance? Like, you can just get a Shadow Blade or something.
Yes, because the thing is, at some point you do need damage even on Shadow Fiend, and if you go blink BKB, you're never gonna have damage, and then you just lost the game before you get anything.
I had 74 damage though.
The other thing is, because they have a Nexus Assassin on the Dire, they're gonna be motivated to buy Sentry Wards anyway, so Shadow Blade's gonna do nothing, as he's actually glimpsed back into a nice Static Storm with no Shadow Grave coming here from Dazzle, the Dust as well, they're like, fuck you, if the Nexus Assassin here, let's kill him. 4 staff forward. And the orbs, he's gonna die. Where's Nyx? He TP'd out. He lived.
It's not as bad as it looks like. Like, they've still got anti-mage farming. As long as they don't get, like, multiple wrecks, they're totally fine.
Yeah. I wanna talk, like, you gotta weigh up a big gamble. If you've already got a hero that goes invis, you've gotta gamble on whether it's worthwhile getting an invis item, because the enemy's already motivated to get the vision out, and with you having a Shadow Blade, they're even more motivated, which kind of makes it, like, worthless, if they're diligent with the wards. But they're hitting on the tier 3. No response from Boats Don't Leave Footprints, apart from a Fortify, dank.
And Mage on top.
Anti-Mage is top. Is there TPs on
the Radiant?
TP. No TP on OD, but everyone has a TP in back. He's blunked away. Where is he? There he is.
That's the usual Manta style timing on M. Isn't it 25 something?
Yeah. It's like is Storm, it? Orchid, Bloodstone.
Yeah.
It depends if you're going like Vlad's or Vanguard in between. Like, if you go straight the Manta after Battle Fury, you can get like 20 minutes.
But do you want to do that? Probably not, right?
Well, if you want like very efficient farming.
Is it? Because you take a lot of damage if you don't have Vanguard or Vlad's. I don't think you can reliably farm, like, forever.
Yeah, maybe.
Gonna point out that the OD just two-hit Dazzle.
Yeah.
Poor Dazzle.
Oh god. You got a Hyperstone. It should be 2 Moonshards at least.
Of course.
Moonshard, that was underrated item. Usually buy them on supports.
Yeah. Like Omni.
Best bang for your buck, not Oracle. Because he's got such a, like, fast attack speed anyway, it's like even more. It's like 3 orbs in the air before
base
I can hit
attack
someone.
Time is what you're looking for.
Mm-hmm. No damage, you don't need damage. Just as long as you got base attack speed.
Doesn't what? Smoke though.
Where?
There. Like,
on Dazzle.
Okay.
By Reddit. He just dewarded two
smart,
enemy wards.
It's smart, he smoked a ward.
Is it though?
Yeah.
Yeah, like he dewarded enemy wards and put his own ward there.
They still know he's there, though, if he does it. So, it doesn't really help.
If they're paying extreme attention. Nyx has Axe, though. Clown. He's a little mound. The range on some of his stuff now is ridiculous. Spike Carapace as well, it's like an area of effect thing. Oh, and Disruptor just goes around and dewards all the Dazzle's hard work. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Adamage is doing a pretty good job though. Simplejack getting the split push on. Got his Manta. So 26 and a half minutes from Vlad's Manta, Battle Fury treads. It's alright considering the game.
I think you died 3 times.
Last
yeah.
Hits. 181. That's not bad. Doing a zapped.
Yeah.
Full retard mode team fight.
Could have been better.
Yeah, like if you have complete free farm, you could easily be at 260 right now.
Yeah.
How can you know that?
Because
what's like the last hits per time ratio?
10 minutes, 10 last hits per minute is like if you have free farm, what you should get.
After.
But there's
minutes.
Only there's only 2 creep waves a minute, and there's 4 creeps in
each
wave. Well,
that's why you jungle too.
Like,
I think that I got once 150 last hits at 50 minutes, which is pretty good. I don't know what the best is you could get. I think.
Oh, are they killing him? Yes.
I think I saw in a program, I saw 100 at 10 minutes once.
Yeah. Arteezy had 96 at 9 minutes 50 when I was watching the game. That's because he was farming the wave and then he'd go into the hard camp because he was dire.
Yeah.
He'd just go straight to the hard camp and use Dark Pact and farm that and then go back to the wave.
But having like 260 at 26 minutes isn't actually hard, I think. If you somewhat know what you're doing with farming patterns.
It is actually a Moonshard and it's Roshan time. 16 stolen int, probably all from the Anti-Mage. He deals 174 base plus whatever the donk. Wait, is his Arcane Orb multiplier added to his base attack? Or is it something that's added on afterwards?
It's not a multiplier, so... It's just...
It's a pure...
Yeah, it's just pure damage based on his mana pool.
But
yes,
is it added to the 174? Or
yes.
Is it already in that 174?
No, it's on top of it.
Wow.
So, right now, it's approximately 200 extra damage, if he has it full mana.
No, it's the mana pool, not mana. It's the full.
No, it's stolen intelligence.
No, it's the current mana he has. So
oh,
he actually
is?
Deals less damage when he has no mana, yeah.
Oh.
So yeah, 10% of 2000 roughly, or 10% of 19, so yeah, 190. No. Yeah.
Well, it's 9%, some 180, maybe.
Yeah, well, roughly 10%.
Yeah.
What can post-only footprints even do?
Let Intermage farm.
The bot lanes. Yeah, he's farming the bot lanes with his illusions just now anyway.
He should.
I think he's too conscientious in helping his team.
Honestly, just give up the Rex. Who cares about that? And go farm.
Yeah, he could have been top right now.
Yeah. Or bot. It's a huge mistake for him to stay here. Like, if you lose one Rex, that doesn't really matter. If you have Intermage. I think he has Manta now. He probably wants a BKB. As soon as possible. And if he has that, he can definitely start fighting. So maybe 5-6 more minutes of him farming instead of trying to fight, and they should be fine.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Hmm. Everything's happening. Everything's happening at once. Omni-Knight ultimate, Stack Storm. It's only on 2 though. The rest of the heroes are going to be running outside. Shallowgrave onto the Omni-Knight is going to make sure he can survive a little way through this. And the illusions from the Darkseer world are actually doing a lot of damage. With Mad Monocle running through, he's going to die to Thunderblast. And one light last right click from the Outworld Devourer. Jin Graze, double kill, killing spree. No, Simple Jack on a double kill, but he can't really do much else. The OD is back after they spend the ages. So they lose 2. There's going to be a buyback on the next Assassin. It's pretty good buyback if they can make something happen. Monster kill, double kill, because Omni-Knight and Botanius, you just don't respect this Devourer. He is out of this world, so the Nyx is going to sit himself in. They have the Sentry Ward doesn't actually reach him, and they have one more, but they can find him now. They're going to throw the Poison Dagger through, get the Thunderstrike on. Nyx, realizing he's in danger, is going to come out of that form, and Anti-Mage is going to run himself in, but with the Rod of Atos.
I'm not quite sure what they're doing here. Like, Anti-Mage in the fight before, he did get a double kill, but he didn't really do anything the whole fight. Like,
diving forward.
He hit a few times some people, and I guess got some last hits, but he didn't actually achieve anything in this fight, and I wonder why he's not pushing. Like, they should just give up on those Rex. They don't need to buyback for it. Just let Intermage farm. Like, there's no reason to play so risky right now.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Well, I mean,
there's just no way Antimage is gonna fight against OD right now without PKB. It just doesn't work. So he doesn't even have to try it, really.
He needs a PKB or an Abyssal Blade.
Yeah.
What's the BKB gonna do? Because the
make you immune to Arcane Orb. It doesn't pierce the immunity. Pure. Doesn't matter.
Oh. Okay. Damages pure, but doesn't pierce it.
There you go. Buy a BKB. It's about 1k off it.
So it does pierce magic resistance, like the Oracle disarm thing. But if you're actually magic immune, like BKB or Repel, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
You learn something new every day, folks. Lootacast presents knowledge bombs. This is what usually happens. We're so fucking insightful. But yes. I don't think there was an issue with the Nyx Assassin buyback. He's got his Aghanim Scepter. Anything else on top of this is luxury.
No, it's not a problem, but there's just no need for it. So he could have hit like 1k more gold right now.
But then they maybe would have taken the racks if he hadn't. I don't know, like it... This could be the thing that comes back to save them. If the Radiant have to spend... We still haven't given them a name. If the Radiant need to do, like... designate more timing to get in the mid racks instead of already having taken them. Like, maybe that buyback will prove useful. Antimage is going to TP out after pushing in the bot lane. And the rest of the Radiant are actually here. They found the next assassin because they've got a gem on the OD. Spike Carapace is going to stop both of them, especially seeing as the Radiant Spurn is going to proc it on the Spectre. But with the Hurricane Pike slash 4 staff forward from... blah, 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 blah. He is now godlike after getting the last right click onto the Nyx Assassin, who's out for 50 seconds with no buyback. Antimage is now here in the base again. I'm sure Tungler has something to say about that.
I already said everything about that.
Don't
yeah.
Do it.
Well, he's going for BKB now. That's gonna help. But it's just, yeah.
Yeah, there's actually no point being here because he's doing nothing to stop them from taking the racks. He's just running around. And they're gonna turn their attentions onto the top. But they still can't really do anything,
no,
can they?
They can't. And that's why you'd like to have an Antimage right now. He's dead.
Antimage.
They're all dead.
A nice back wall onto the Omni Knight. That is them dead. There's
that's why you want Antimage right now on the bottom lane, because then they can't go for top. But
Omni is
like
dead.
That is a snooze.
Antimage buys back and he gets glimpsed. Well, BKB from the Eye Devourer, he's just even more unkillable. Drops a slammer of an ultimate with the two right clicks. Oh, three right clicks. No! BKB saving him from the pure damage. But that's a die back there from the Antimage. He is dead and out for over 90 seconds. And when the Shadow Fiend's still having to regen in base, now he comes out, he's using his bottle to get a little bit of health. But everyone on this team. Team! Disco Spider, question mark. Some BM here. We'll call them Dickhead. Right, okay, the Radiant team's called Dickhead. Because they're giving it all that. But the fact back the mound that is Nyx and with a gem, holy shit! Godlike. OD, even kill the courier. You know what? That's just unnecessary. Saving strat, says Brutus. That's exactly what's going on here.
So, I think the big problem in that strat was Shadow Fiend, because it's one of the worst heroes in the game right now, and he just completely got destroyed against OD and lost them the lane, the game, actually. Not only the lane. Also, a little bit of decision-making problems with not having Antimage split push. Like, they could easily still be in the game with only one Rex taken, maybe. Yeah, Shadow Fiend is a big problem. That hero doesn't really do anything in general. And Blink Dagger First doesn't help that, really.
Boast only footprints have been granted clemency on one last chance at winning this game as Team Dickheads have decided to bail from pushing the Radiant base. At least for now, turning their attention onto this tier 2 in the bot lane, which is still standing and still at pretty much full health. But not for much longer. He's got two moon shards. You were maybe joking when you said it, but the Outworld Devourer does have two moon shards now. base attack speed of 457, 0.37 attacks per second. Yikes. This is it. This is the last Valiant attempt. Nyx Assassin's going to bury himself way behind the tier 1 turret. Durafeed having to blink out. There you go. There's your Spectre Ultimate. She's going to get herself chasing into the Anti-Mage. The back wall is on absolutely hee-haw, but with the Abyssal Blade onto the Anti-Mage, she's going to be purified and then repelled so that the Spectre can focus in. But the rest of her team are doing what they're supposed to be doing. Team Tickheads are taking the objectives. Anti-Mage is running now. There's a BKB from the Shadow Fiend, but he's not going to hit anyone with his ult. The Oracle's going to get caught on the sidelines, but OG Ash will imprison himself. He's going to come back now, and he's just going to turn his attention to the enemy. Right click, bam, 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 bam. Bye, Dazzle. Bye, Omni-Knight. Wicked sick. Shadow Fiend is on the map. Man Monocle was out way far out. Now he's in a static storm, and now he's dead. Next Assassin can only do one thing, is turn around and impale the Spectre. She's chasing him down, but she's got Radiant. She probably die the fountain if she wanted to. Here you go, Mad Monaco's back. They still have single jack. This is it, boys. With the back, well, just a vac onto the Anti-Mage. They're going to throw the Spectre Dagger forward. It's going to hit onto the Anti-Mage, Monitor Illusions. And with the little mound throwing out these little impales, it's going to try and keep them back. But Disco Spider says GG, well played. Unfortunately, you still have to suffer through this, Disco Spider. You can't GG out this game. Bam, 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 bam. That will devour you, monster. He's killing them right in center. Here goes Shiva's Guard, even on the Darks here. Are they going to dive the base? No, they're going to glimpse back at the Shadow Fiend, and with the creep vision, oh, the ultimate, oh, it was nearly enough to kill him, but it does kill the Dazzle, whose last active duty before dying was to put the Shadow Fiend in a Shadow Grave, but with Astral Imprison going to kill him when he comes out of that, because that Shadow Grave doesn't last long enough, and the damage coming out will be enough to fall. Repel. Yes, so you won't take as much damage, but you still take damage.
So,
Darks here plays into the trees and tries to bring them back out. Can you not fountain kill us?
I just remembered they got an Omni Knight in their game.
Brutus is doing good, man. Don't you dare diss Brutus. He just didn't buy Scaddy. That's probably why they lost. Boom, boom, boom. Dead.
So why did he never repair Anti-Mage before? Like before they had Megas.
There's a smoke. Oh, there's an impale! They can kill the Disruptor before the Fountain dies. He's gonna get the Weave off with the Mana Burn. It was so close, but he's gonna use the Grave and he's gonna get healed up. He's gonna get Stag Storm onto three, and it's over. Radiant victory. Team Dickheads win. Yeah. What a luck we got a forfeit Haggis, isn't it? Yeah, it was. You had, like, great game. I picked you up, bro. Bye, Scaddy, next time. Haggis, add me. Okay. Mad Monocle, you're pretty cool. I will add you. You know what? I'll add everyone in that one. I'll add you and Disco Spider. And Hove. The other guy. Oh, wait, he was Disco Spider. Simple Jack, that's it. Anyway. Afterthoughts. Aptly named Team Dickhead will win against Boats Don't Leave Footprints.
Zapped. Game. Any afterthoughts?
Yeah, Zapped, give us your analysis, bruv.
Anti-Mage stayed too long with this team and didn't get enough money. I would say.
Also, Shadow Fiend is a terrible hero.
That is also a valid point.
Yes, all valid points. Valid points indeed.
How can Shadow Fiend get more last hit than an Anti-Mage? I don't understand it.
Just because you're used to me giving you all the farm in a game, so you race ahead with last hits.
No, but it's
maybe there's more of a last hit, like, spread in Boats Don't Leave Footprints. Maybe their carry isn't a big fucking megalomaniac with last hits, and just last hits the entire map.
But then you can play Anti-Mage.
That's true. Yeah, exactly. Simple Jack, lesson learned, you need to be a big dickhead to play Anti-Mage. You can't,
like
help your team, you can't, yeah, pretty much like Zapped. Just watch a Zapped game where we'll all die and he doesn't give a shit because he's pushing out bot lane. That's how you play Anti-Mage. Don't help your team, fuck your team.
Then he gets a rapier and feeds it in the enemy fountain and then we lose.
That was Slark.
Yeah,
that was Anti-Mage.
Yeah.
That was Slark.
Even worse.
One of our first fucking games and he's like, I didn't dive the fountain. It's like, you did Zapped. Didn't die in the base. You dived the fucking fountain with a rapier and we lost the game. Don't do that. And don't buy Midas. Ever.
On everything hero. Multiple times.
Okay. Microphone. That's it. We are done. Activated. What a shame there was no official game, but a nice podcast anyway. No outro, because fuck it, I don't care. It's too unofficial. Thanks for watching, guys. Good night from me.
Good night.
Good night. From me.
Bye. Bye.
Zapped. Lotica's core player.
What a cast, boys. What a legendary cast.
A good one.